Good morning. Welcome to St. Patrick's Cathedral. Today is the solemnity of the Most Sacred Heart of Jesus. Our celebrant is Bishop Whalen. This Mass is being offered for Maureen Hopkins.
The worship program for this morning celebration can be downloaded at www.stpatrickscathedral.org/live. Hymns can be found in the blue St. Michael's hymnal. At this time, we invite you to rise for the entrance hymn, number 534, God is Love, number 534.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, peace be with you. On this feast of the Sacred Heart of Jesus, we thank God for the gift of his love, and we ask pardon for the times we have failed to bring that love alive for others. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Loving God, who in the heart of your Son, wounded by our sins, bestow on us in mercy the boundless treasures of your love. Grant, we pray, that in paying him the homage of our devotion, we may also offer worthy reparation. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "You are a people sacred to the Lord your God. He has chosen you from all the nations on the face of the earth to be a people peculiarly his own. It was not because you are the largest of all nations that the Lord set his heart on you and chose you, for you are really the smallest of all nations. It was because the Lord loved you and because of his fidelity to the oath he had sworn to your fathers that he brought you out with his strong hand from the place of slavery and ransomed you from the hand of Pharaoh, king of Egypt. Understand then that the Lord your God is God indeed, the faithful God who keeps his merciful covenant down to the thousandth generation toward those who love him and keep his commandments, but who repays with destruction a person who hates him. He does not dally with such a one, but makes them personally pay for it. You shall therefore carefully observe the commandments, the statutes, and the decrees that I enjoin on you today." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord's kindness is everlasting to those who fear him.
The Lord's kindness is everlasting to those who fear him.
Bless the Lord, O my soul. All my being, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits.
The Lord's kindness is everlasting to those who fear him.
He pardons all your iniquities, heals all your ills. He redeems your life from destruction, crowns you with kindness and compassion. The Lord's kindness is everlasting to those who fear him. Merciful and gracious is the Lord, slow to anger and abounding in kindness. Not according to our sins does he deal with us, nor does he requite us according to our crimes.
The Lord's kindness is everlasting to those who fear him. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. At that time, Jesus exclaimed, "I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to the little ones. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves, for my yoke is easy and my burden light." The Gospel of the Lord. Fitting that the gospel on this Feast of the Sacred Heart of Jesus talks about children, because for most of us as children, we remember those pictures of the Sacred Heart. Everyone had them at home. And as a kid, the thing that used to kind of make you wonder was how, no matter where you were in the room, Jesus was looking directly at you. So you would see, you'd look on one side of the room, you'd run across the room, he was looking at you there, you'd run back across the other side of the room, he was looking at you there, and especially in the classroom. There we were, 55 boys in the classroom, one nun. We could do mental math, no machinery, says a lot. But there we all were, and no matter where you were in the room, Jesus was looking directly at you. Now, you could look at that in either of two ways. Either Jesus is looking at you to catch you, or Jesus is looking out for you. And that's the Feast of the Sacred Heart. That Jesus has his eyes on each and every one of us. He sees us as we are for who we are and loves us all the same. And because of that, we know that we're always under his watchful gaze, and that means we need to look with his eyes upon others. On this Feast of the Sacred Heart, we stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, and who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. As one family of faith, we bring the Father all our needs. We pray first for the Church, God's people, that we may be willing to look with the love of Jesus upon all whom we meet. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
On this day of sanctification for priests, we pray for all priests, especially our Holy Father, Pope Francis, our Archbishop, Cardinal Dolan, and all those who serve selflessly in the Church. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
On this Feast of the Sacred Heart of Jesus, we pray especially for those who feel that God does not or cannot love them, that they may recognize that God's love is held out for them, calling them home. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all families, that they may recognize the love of God and their love for one another. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray in a special way for the family of firefighter Mark Batista, who is laid to rest today. We pray for all those who lay their lives on the line to keep us safe. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And finally, we pray for Maureen Hopkins, for whom this Mass is offered, for all our beloved dead. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, we thank you for the gift of your love. Help us to recognize that love as we share it with one another. Hear our needs and answer them if they are in accord with your will, for we ask them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It shall become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It shall become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Lavami, Signore, di tutti i miei scopi, storis mis delitos. Pray now, my sisters and brothers, that this sacrifice, yours and mine, may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look, O Lord, we pray on the surpassing charity in the heart of your beloved Son, that what we offer may be a gift acceptable to you and an expiation of all our offenses. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For raised up high on the cross, he gave himself up for us with a wonderful love and poured out blood and water from his pierced side, the wellspring of the church's sacraments, so that, won over to the open heart of the Savior, all might draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation. And so we join the angels and saints in the hymn of your praise. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took the bread, said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have found us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Timothy, our Bishop, me, your unworthy servant, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them now into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, his spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, St. Patrick, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accord with your will. You who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
We bring that peace to one another. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Of Christ?
Amen.
The body of Christ. Amen. The body
Please
of Christ.
Please join in singing number 560,
The body
Heart
of Christ.
Of Christ. Number 560.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. 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 The body of Christ.
Heart of Christ, we see.
Body of Christ.
Our strength.
Thus says the Lord, let whoever is thirsty come to me and drink. Streams of living water will flow from within the one who believes in me. Let us pray. May this sacrament of charity, O Lord, make us fervor with the fire of holy love, so that, drawn always to your Son, we may learn to see him in our neighbor. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Please join in singing number 674, O Love of God, number 674.